Okay, now the next I'm going to answer for the question 1 to 4. Recall the 1 to 4. First question is frequency and percentage for gender and profession. That's all, only two. And then the second one, find mean and standard deviation. Find mean and standard deviation. Okay. Then third one, find and mean standard deviation for factors 1 to 4. Then last one, charts and graphs. Now I am moving to SPSS window. Okay. Yes, I mean we are in the SPSS. So very simple. Please be very careful on this way. Okay, first one, descriptive statistics. Go to frequencies. The first question is find the frequency and percentage for gender and profession. Okay, now select these two, convert here. Nothing you can do, just click OK. That's all. So what our aim here, male have the 68.4% in total. Out of 100%, male are 68.4% and female are 31.6%. That's all. If you go with the profession, and we will say now, 38.9% are being from the corporate sector. That's all. So sometimes in education department or commerce and management, they will use this percentage value to write the interpretation. For them, you can use this one. Next, you can, the second question, find mean and standard deviation for all statements. Okay, go to analyze, descriptive statistics, frequency, reset. Now you can select statement 1 to 13. Just you can press the shift button and select here. All the 13 statements were selected at a time. So transfer it into variable box. Then click statistics. So I said only mean and standard deviation. If you want median, mode, any other percentile or skewness, kurtosis, you can check the boxes. As per our assignment, I said only mean and standard deviation. So you can check the boxes, mean and standard deviation. Click continue. Okay. See, then within a table, a single table reflects the mean and standard deviation for question statement 1 to 13. That's all. Then third question, find mean and standard deviation with regard to factors 1 to 4. Okay. Go to analyze, descriptives, frequency, reset. Now go to the factors. This is the factors which are created by us, a new variable created by us. Because we gave the name in the label box, that's why it is appear as an individual performance, peer performance. See? Otherwise, you can see it's only a factor 1, 2, 3, 4. That's all. So statistics, mean, standard deviation, continue. Okay. Yes, this is the output. Now I am going with question number 4. I have moved the question number 8 into 4. Prepare suitable graph and charts as appropriate to the data. Even you can compute this graph and charts whenever you go for a inferential statistics. Suppose if you want to calculate independent t-test, where the graphs and charts are available, even you can use from there. Otherwise, if you want any specific chart with this data, you can use the menu, graph menu. Go to legacy dialogs and select whatever you want. Here I would like to show only one example. I will go the by charts, define. So here I want to know the gender and the levels, factor 1 level. Okay, factor 1 level. And even if you want to the team level, you can also insert in and click OK. Now we will check. So male and female. This is a male and female. And here you can see. And instead of adding two many factors into that, I will add only two right now. Okay. So again, I will go and reset it and put in the gender and only one here slices defined slices. So you can keep the slices here. Now put it okay. See, so with the graph you can explain the majority are from the medium. Okay, so even if you want the bar chart, you can go to the bar chart. At least you can use any one or two charts for the assignment purpose. Only minimum two charts you can use it. Okay, go to bar chart. Bar chart, you want to keep the axis gender, and columns if you want to keep the factor level as a column. Okay, then click okay. So you can see this one. That's all. Okay, so likewise you can do at least any two graphs and graph and charts as appropriate to the data. So I think now the second step were completed. So I will see. I think this question, form the frequency and percentage of gender and profession over, find mean and standard deviation for all statement Q1 to Q13 over, find mean and standard deviation with regard to factors is over, and charts and graph is over. Now I am going to do the compare mean. So here, you know, one sample t-test, then independent sample t-test, one way ANOVA. Okay, we can change to output window. Either you can do the calculation from the output window or data window. No issue at all. Both will work. Analyze, compare mean, one sample t-test. Reset it. Here you can see the gender and profession will not appear here, no? Many of us, the same difficulty they find it. Okay.
Yes, yes.
So I can, yeah, I will go to the data window here. Okay. Now you will see the data window. What happened now? Here, what they return? String. Okay. So we have to change into numeric. Okay, because previously when we input the data in this column are in string form, but we have recode it into numerical form, but we have not changed this type. So just change it. So this is the problem most of you have faced while you are doing it. Okay, now the gender and profession were included in the data set. So the question number one sample test for all the 13 statements, we can select all the 13 statements, move into the testing variable. I said you have to fix the fixed value as 3. Why I have set the fixed value as a 3 here? The respondents, sorry, the response are in Likert scale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can add this value, total 15, then go for average, the value is 3. So you have to assume the population or the expected average value is 3. Ram, and the voice was paranga, control pannunga. Mike,
sir. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
So that you have to fix the test value as a 3. Suppose, in case if you know the population average, you can enter the population average here to check whether your respondent below the average of the population or above the population average. So here I put as a 3. Okay. So next, very simple. We can go and click. Okay. That's all. So you will get the output. So this is the total number, 193 participants. So you can see the mean value, almost all of them are above the average level. So you can check with the significant value in this one sample t-test. You can see all statements shows there was a significant difference between the population or fixed value, then they are all above the average level. They are all above the average level.
Such a that window is practically changed.
Oh, it is the output window not appear. Okay, now you can check. Yeah, please, yeah. So this is output window. This is output window. Okay. For one
not
sample.
Not appearing.
This is output. Huh? Yeah,
okay. No, sir. Still
no,
is.
Sir, now, still no, sir. Now it is appearing.
Okay. This is one sample test. Then second one, independent sample t-test. So go to analyze menu. Compare mean. Independent sample t-test. Here I said you can conduct the independent sample test for the factor 1 to 4 factors with regard to with regard to gender and factor 1 to 4. So gender is a categorical variable transferred into grouping variable. Go to the define group. Default it is 1 and 2, so leave it. Click continue. If you give any other thing, you know, like 3 and 4, then you have to modify it, otherwise leave it. And then next you can go to select the all the four factors transferred in the testing variable and click OK. So the other options are as per the default settings, so leave it. Okay, so this is some descriptive statistics for the independent sample test, and here you can see the t-test value.
Can you repeat it, sir, please?
Yeah, the window will not. I'm right. Repeat.
Kindly repeat it, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, go sir. To compare means independent sample t-test. The gender grouping where you can transfer the gender into grouping variable, and define one for male, two for group female. Then next you can transfer the factor 1, factor 2, factor 3, factor 4 into testing variable. Just click OK. That's all. When you click OK, this window will appear. This is the descriptive and this is the t-test. This is the t-test value. And you can see the significant level here. There was no significant difference at all. Okay. Then next one, ANOVA for with regard to factors. Go to analyze menu. Compare one-way ANOVA. Then here you have to transfer the profession into the factor list. And you can also convert... transfer the all the four factors into the dependent list. Then if you want to compute post-hoc test, again this post-hoc test I already given in my PowerPoint. What are all the most stringent, what are all the least important, and what are all the when we have to use, when the assumption are met, when there is no equal variances. So we used to keep always CEFI as a post-hoc test in our department. So I click the CEFI and continue, and you can go with it. Even if you want the effect size, then you can click the effect size or just click OK. So this is ANOVA table. So there is no descriptive. If you want to have a descriptive, because most of the research, they also mention mean and standard deviation.
So sir, kindly show it once more.
Yeah. So analyze, compare mean. One-way ANOVA and reset, I am reset. Then profession is converted into factor. Then factor 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a scaled variable. So I am moving to the dependent list. Then post-hoc, you can select CEFI. Somebody select, you know, least significant difference or Turkey. Okay. So according to the nature of the study, it will change. Okay. So now I am using the CEFI. Continue, and in the option you can click descriptive and homogeneity. So here the Levani will appear to check the assumption of this ANOVA. The Levani will give whether the error within all the three groups are equal or not. So when the error within the group is equal, then you are the one of the assumptions were met, then you can continue with ANOVA. Otherwise you can go with the alternative in non-parametric side. That's why we can use these two checkboxes. Okay, then here means plot is there, you can click it. Okay, then click OK. So here you can see previously we won't get the descriptive, now we will get the descriptive. Mean, standard deviation, standard error, even you can write with the standard error also. This is a test of homogeneity of variances. So you can see based on mean, we have to check with the mean. So here it shows 0.22 above 0.05 level, which means all the groups are having equal variances within. We want to find out the variances between. Okay, ANOVA want to find out the true variance between, but at the same time, there is no difference in the within group variances. If you want to check, you can use this homogeneity. That's a Levani test statistics, which is used for this one. Okay, here you can check. It is above 0.05. Okay, right. This is ANOVA table. F ratio shows 0.08. There was no significant difference among low, moderate, and high performer in the individual performance. here in team performance, peer group performance, you can see it is significant at 0.05 level. That means you have to check with the postdoc. You have to check with the postdoc, the order of rank, you have to check with the postdoc. Okay, next in factor 3, no significant difference. And in factor 4, no significant difference. So factor 2, significant difference. We will check with the, this is a postdoc test, paired mean test. So academician corporate, no difference. Academician and others, yes, there is a difference, 0.03. less than 0.05. So here you have to write your interpretation. You have to explain the reason behind this difference. So you have to write an explanation for this value. Okay, that's the postdoc test. I am using CEFI here. So academician and corporate, when we compare academician with the corporate, no difference. But when we compare academician with others, it's a difference. Okay, and also a corporate with others, it's also significant different. It's also significant. Academician and corporate have a significant difference with others, but within each other there is no difference. That shows through this postdoc test. Okay, that's all in ANOVA. So next we move on to the see here. Correlation. So compute the correlation. So the question number 8, you know, test whether significant association between factor 1 and 4. Test whether significant prediction between, that means you have to use the multiple correlation or linear regression, between team performance with a factor or team performance with a statement also. You can also check that statement. Okay, now I am moving to the SPSS window. Okay, analyze. Now correlation, bivariate. So I'm going to find the correlation matrix of factor 1, factor 2, factor 3 and overall. Okay, convert it into here. Then Spearman already default, and if you want to check the Spearman, you can check the Spearman because it is it's a scaled variable, so you can go with the Pearson and click OK. So this is the correlation matrix. You will check individual performance with the peer team. Yes, double star. Double star indicate 0.01 level significant difference. Double star. Okay. It's also individual with the organizer. Yeah, association. There was a significant association between individual performance and peer group performance. Individual performance with the organizer performance. Individual performance with the team performance. So this is a correlation matrix. Then next, I'm going to calculate the multiple correlation. It is available in the...
Sir, please repeat this step again.
Okay, go to analyst menu. Correlate. Select bivariate. Okay. Reset. Here only we need to have the a significant association among the factors. So factor 1, factor 2, factor 3, and total converted into variable and leave it others. If you want the descriptive mean and standard deviation, you can click the mean and standard deviation, continue and click OK. So see, this is a descriptive statistics of these four factors. Already we calculated many times, and you can see the correlation value here, the correlation value. The double star indicates asterisk, you know, it is 0.01 level significant. And if it is a single star, it says 0.05. I think in this result, almost all the results are having a significant difference at 0.01 level, 0.01 level. That means we have to reject the null hypothesis at 1% level of significance. Okay, next, the multiple correlation, go to regression. In that, you have to select linear. Regression linear. Okay, here the team performance is the dependent. The factor 1, factor 2, factor 3 is a independent. Here there are number of ways are there. Stepwise, remove, backward and forward. That means if you put up forward, it select the variable which has a high close relationship with the team performance. Okay, so you can select either this or that, or you can enter here. Just enter, go to statistics. Then here, if you want to have the R squared, this is some multiple correlation value. Descriptive. Here you can see. Emma, sounds part and partial correlations. See, and then covariance matrix. Here, multiple correlation, descriptive, part and partial correlations are available. Okay, continue. Click OK. So this is the descriptive, and this is the correlation. See, you can see the variables entered in this correlation. This is called as, you know, almost this variables was very close relationship with the and the dependent variable, because already we we already saw that all the correlation go matrix are more than 0.01 level. So this is the way we have to predict. And one more I conduct with the R statement. So we can go and linear here. Instead of keeping this one, I would like to put the 1 to 13 questions. So we will find the forward selection method and statistics. Okay, all are same. Then click OK. So this is a correlation now. So this is order now. Q7 has the more contribution. In the overall, the question or statement Q7 has a very close relationship with the team performance, overall team performance. So this is the order entered into the correlation matrix. You can see the correlation matrix. It started with the correlation matrix with the first variable 0.72, 72% it has a correlation. The second variable, when we add the second statement, this is the correlation value, and this is the okay. So this is a multiple correlation. You can check this is a multiple correlation. So from which we are going to have the prediction. This is unstandardized coefficient value. This is standardized coefficient value. Finally, you can see this is a constant. Okay, this is the constant value by which we are going to create. By which we are going to create an equation. Y is equal to a plus x1, this value, plus x2, this value, plus x3. So that is the way we have to create the prediction equations. So that you can use. There are two methods of preparing the equation. One is a unstandardized formula. Other one is a standardized formula. Using the raw score is called as an unstandardized prediction equation. Using the Z score, you have to use this standardized coefficient equations. Okay, so that's all about the assignments data set from one, and now move on to the data set two assignments. I think one more left. See, compute non-parametric test. So one sample, independent sample, and dependent sample. So we will move to the
non-parametric test.
Parametric. So, okay. Go to the analyst menu. Non-parametric. Click one sample. Click one sample. You can leave it. You can just click automatically run. Nothing you can do it. So automatically it select the variable which has the nominal and ordinal. So it's the lengthiest calculation because, you know, here you can see this side. This is the results of the one sample t-test. Here, binomial test taken for the male and female because only two respondents. Male and female, it's the binomial respondents so taken for the analysis. And high square for all other things because in a question one, five low, medium, high. Okay, that's why it take it. The high square for question 1 to 13 in profession 3 level. Only if it is a 2 level, the binomial test. And if it is a 2 and more, automatically high square will be computed. And this is a scaling data. That's why it's a Kolmogorov-Smirnov test used. Scaling data. It's also one sample non-parametric test. So automatically it will select the suitable test for your data. Otherwise, if you want to compute anything specifically, you can go legacy dialog and use high square if you want, binomial if you want, run if you want, then one sample one. So I am going one sample. Okay. So I want to conduct this, you know, gender. So only one sample. options to this A, then you can click. That's all. It's one sample. Okay. So that is a way to compute non-parametric for one sample. The same way, non-parametric. It is very easy to compute. You can go to independent samples. So automatically, but for here in the field, you have to mention the grouping variable. So grouping variable and transfer this one here. So you can see here, where you can use whether scaled data or ordinal data. Only two type of data can be used in the test field. Now you can run it. Just now you can run it. So only the distribution here you can see Mann-Whitney U-test. Mann-Whitney, because Genter has two level. The Mann-Whitney test is used to the alternative for independent t-test. If it is a three level, then automatically the other statistics will be chosen. We will check again. Go to non-parametric, independent sample. Instead of Genter, you can use the profession level. So here it is three. The category is three. Run. Now you can check. Driscoll Wally test is used for one-way ANOVA. The alternative ANOVA is called as a Driscoll Wally. See here. The profession with the factor one individual performance, peer performance with the profession. What we did in one-way ANOVA, the same thing we can do it in a non-parametric as a Kruskal-Wallis test. Kruskal-Wallis test. When we violated the assumption for one-way ANOVA, I said the Levani homogeneity and the normality test. If we violated the normality and the homogeneity test, then automatically you have to move to the non-parametric. Parallel test is called as a Kruskal-Wallis test. Okay. And then K-related sample. All right. Here we can go to the... So in parametric, we used one-way repeated Mrs. ANOVA. Here we are going to use the Friedman test. So we will check related sample. Then automatically... Okay. So just run it. Just run it. Run. So no field have been selected for the test field. So go to the field. Now you can select. So here you can see test 1, test 2, test 3, test 4. Tested at a different time period. Now you can run it. So see, two-way analysis of variance by rank. Friedman is an alternative for one-way repeatedness. Okay. Now, and the next... new share. Okay. See, next assignment, compute the repeated Mrs. ANOVA and ANOCOVA. So the first one, test whether significant changes between pre-test and post-test or test 1 and test 2. Here, you know, the samples are tested twice. When the means are taken from the same sample in different conditions, maybe before the match or after the match, or before the treatment or after the treatment. In such a condition, you can use a paired sample t-test. Then one-way ANOVA with repeated messes. This is the one-way ANOVA with repeated messes is extension of this paired sample t-test. Extension of paired sample t-test. The paired sample uses only two mean, but one-way ANOVA uses more than two mean. Even in the lecture itself, I told, when we do the one-way ANOVA for suppose if you want to measure the observational study, day 1, day 2, day 3, if you are test the same thing, you know, day 1, day 2, day 3, up to 10 days. Here you have tested the same sample for 10 days. So when that condition, you can use the one-way ANOVA. And if you have a control group with the pre and post, that's called as a covariate. If you have a covariate, then you can use the analysis of covariance. So now we move on to the SPSS window. So go to analyze. The first one, paired sample t-test. So click paired sample t-test. Okay, reset. Here we have to make a pair. So pre-test and post-test. Select the both, converted into the paired sample t-test. Here I am using column the pre-test and post-test, but we have to do for each group separately. In our data, it is going to take the results of entire groups. So I would like to show the data set. So it's a data set here. You can see in the data set here, you know, group one. That's all. So if you want to compute paired sample test for group one alone, then you have to delete the rest of the data. So I used to delete it usually. So I deleted no data here. Okay, only the group one pre and post here. So likewise, you have to conduct for group two and group three and group four. So paired sample test will be used for only one group, right? So what I used to test, I have deleted. Then I will conduct one and group one. Then again, I control Z. All my data again regained back. All my data regained back. Okay, all my data regained back. Then I will delete this one and three and four. Now I complete the paired sample t-test for group two. Well, then after output, then I put Z, control Z, undo option. I am using the undo option. Now I am going to delete one and two. So this is the way I used to do. Otherwise, in the Excel itself, you can keep the data in such a way so that it is easy for you to calculate t-test. So here I am going to, for example, I am going to use the entire pre and post. I am considering it is only one group. Okay, I am considering it is only one group. Okay. So option, nothing, and I'm going to click OK. So here you can see the paired sample t-test. It's a 5.8. Then significant value shows less than 0.05. That means there was a significant improvement before and after the treatment. There was a significant improvement between pre and post test. That's all for the paired sample
test. Window is not visible.
Yeah. Wait. Okay, now you can see the output. Here you can, it's output t-test 5.88. It shows there was a significant, because it is less than 0.05 level. So there was a significant difference between pre and post test. That means before and after the treatment or baseline treatment. Okay, so next, one way repeated measure, go to general linear model, go to repeated measure. Here you have to give the test. We have conducted the test at a different times. So kindly give test. How many level? 4 times. A group tested 4 times. Add it. Define it. Then here you can see test 1, test 2, test 3, test 4. Transfer into within subject variable. That's all. If you have a different level, 2 group, with 4 times if you are testing, then it's a 2 × 4 repeated measure ANOVA on last factor. In such a condition, you can convert that group. Suppose if you are using 2 groups, otherwise you can only one group, more number of tests, use only this, that's all. Okay, so if you want to have a postdoc, you can use the post-hoc test. I think it is because there is no group between factors, so it will not appear. Then you can find the means, you can use it. And here you can use it for Frani test as a post-hoc. Continue, because this test will use now in between groups. If there is a between group, the other post-hoc test will appear. Here it will not appear. Suppose if I am converting the profession here now, then you... Because data were not ordered for the profession. So sorry. Okay. So only we have the one-way ANOVA, and go to click OK. So this is the output. Multivariate. Then there's a sphericity now. Sphericity. It's a test used for one of the assumption tests used in one-way repeated message ANOVA. And here you can see if the sphericity is assumed. Here you can see, yeah, sphericity is not assumed because it's so significant. So either you can take this Greenhouse's Scissor value or the other two value. If it is not significant, you can check the first row. This one has a F value. Okay. So now almost all the F values are similar here. So you can use in your table these two. Sum of squares 233.27, DF3 and mean square and EF. Error, I said, you know, within, the other name for within is called as a error. This is within. So here you can take this, only you can take this two row. Row, the bottom row, and this is only upper row. For giving the value in your thesis or research work. That's all for the one-way repeated messes, ANOVA. Then you can also check the post-hoc differences. Here you can see the F ratio. F ratio is significant or not, you can check here. Yes, F ratio is significant. Then if F ratio is significant, you can go to the post hoc here. This is the post hoc. So you can compare test 1 to test 2. Yes, almost all pairs are significant except 3 and 4. Almost all other pairwise comparison are significant. So that means, you know, There was a significant difference between test 1 and test 2. Test 1 and test 3. Test 1 and test 4. That's the interpretation. Okay, next, the final one, analysis of covariance. So, go to general linear model, univariate, check the grouping variable. Here, the group here is there into the fixed factors. And this is a post-test, will be converted into dependent variable, and pre-test will be converted into covariate. So this is a baseline measurement. I am keeping baseline measurement as a covariate. So I am going to find out the variance on post-test by keeping pre-test as a baseline. All right. So go to option, descriptive, homogeneity. If you want to discuss size, power, check it out. Okay, continue, and also don't forget to check the estimated marginal mean. That is the adjusted post-test mean. Estimated marginal mean is nothing but adjusted post-test mean. Click it and use the compare. The Bonferrani recommended. Continue. Okay. So you can see in the Levani source, significant difference. That means a violations. The assumption are violated. It's the value should above 0.05. Here 0.03. It shows that equality of variance are violated. Okay. And this is the, here in analysis of covariance, you can check only these two row. I would like to highlight it. Yes, you can check these two row, the group and error, group and error, only you can check these two. So this is the F value, you can take it for a discussion. This is the F value. The eta squared is nothing but effect of the significant amount of changes due to the training. The eta squared is nothing but here 67% changes due to the treatment. That is the meaning of here. 67.7% effect size are explained through the independent variable on dependent variable. That's the eta squared. Okay. So this is the F value. This is estimated marginal mean is called as an adjusted post-test mean. The peculiarity of the analysis of covariance, nullifying the initial mean differences among the groups. You have to set the initial mean difference equally, but it is not possible to keep the initial mean difference equally because of our selection process. So definitely there may be a slight up and down in the mean value of all the four groups. What ANOVA did, it equalizes all the four into in a simple value. Equalizes all the four into single value. And after that, it will find the real changes due to the treatment. That's why the post-test were adjusted. The post-test were adjusted. A new mean were created. That's called as an adjusted post-test. That's all. All the assignment process were explained clearly. And now it's open to all of you. You can ask any doubt.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Go to file and go to. Where is it? Export. See here, export.
Where it is available, sir?
The file menu. In the file menu, you can see. I think it's two window is here, right? In file menu, see export. Okay. Is it visible now? Export.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, click it. So these are all the file format. These are all the file format. If you want to export in Excel, it is in the output window. It is in the output window. If you want to export Excel, PowerPoint, or HTML, or Word. So I would like to export the file into Word format. Okay. You have to select the destination folder. So I am going to keep it in the desktop. Okay. I'm going to name it SPSS FDB. Kindly, if you are going to name now, you can name it in your mail, drskseedu@gmail.com. Because the mail ID only the unique ID for the participants. Because in Dr. S. Seedu, there are three or more persons are there. So it is a bit confusion. If you are storing your file in your mail ID, it is unique. So I am saving in the name of my email ID. Okay, save it. Right. Now click OK. At the bottom, you can see at the bottom, click OK. Okay. So the file is, you know, exporting. File is exporting. Where I have to take the Google Drive? In your mail. Open your Gmail. Go here. And select this drive. So here you can do new. What do you want to do? File upload. Okay, file upload. Then select the file. It's in the desktop. So it's in the desktop. I will select the here you can see Dr. SK say that Gmail. It's a Word file. So I'm going to open it. So the file is uploaded into the Google Drive. See, check the file is uploaded in Google Drive. Right click it and get shareable link. See here. Right click it, get shareable link. Just click it. And here, what you have to give, just copy, don't copy alone. You can also give the permission. Most of you have the restricted yourself. Then again, I am putting in a request to you. So here you can see anyone with this link. Just click anyone with this link. Then you can copy. You can copy the link. Now you can go to Bodhi tree. This is the Bodhi tree. You can go to the Bodhi tree. Ram, Bodhi tree Tharida?
Yes, sir.
Sir, there is.
Okay, Bodhi tree. And you can see other lab. Click assignment on data analysis. Okay, so here the first question, whether data analysis for the questions are done. Yes, very simple answer, yes. Save and answer close. Okay, which version of SPSS software is used? 27, save and close. And provide the Google Drive link, answer.
Sir, version, where do we find in this? Where do we find the version?
I property? Think help, help.
Help, okay, okay, okay.
Okay. Okay. Here, you know, I just pasted the link here. Save and close. Right. Save all answer. Press the button, save all answer first. Then freeze submission. It will ask. You can't modify your answer after this. Yes. Freeze it. Okay, done it. That's all.